sorry. Anyhow, now we are in the pleural cavity. And I do this together with Professor Rückert, who is at the Charité and he's responsible for the thoracic department, but because I do a lot of the surface malignancy, we do these cases together, and I'm proud to present something here. So just to start with an overview, of course, these are rare tumors. We talk about 2% of the chest tumors. Men have more diseases than women, and in Europe, or WHO estimates that this is asbestosis-related disease, and it accounts something about 100,000 deaths per year globally, so it is at least something. We have a long latency between exposure and disease, something about 20 to 25 years. And we think that in Germany, at least, we have the most patients coming in 2020 to 2050. We have then the most patients with pleural mesothelioma as well as peritoneal mesothelioma. And as you can see, in Europe, for Great Britain, France, and the Netherlands, something around 2 to 3 persons per 100,000 inhabitants. So it is rare. We have to know something about the pathology. It is a heterogeneous kind group of tumors. We have to know, the pathologist has us to tell something about the tissue invasion, so you have to ask him to figure out if there is something or not. We have to know something about the the EHC. It is recommended for the primary diagnosis of malignant pleural mesothelioma, and the pathologist has to do twice. He has to do the markers for mesothelial disease and additionally to look if it is a mesothelioma or if it is adenocarcinoma. He also have to look for the markers of adenocarcinoma. And at the moment, we have three main subtypes of the mesothelioma. This is the epithelioid, the biphasic, and the sarcomatoid subtype of mesothelioma, which is pleural as well as in the abdominal cavity. And the epithelioid is the better one. Sarcomatoid has a very bad prognosis. Coming to the staging, well, in the thoracic situation, you first have to know something about the history of the patients. You have to ask him, was there any exposure to asbest? Then, of course, we have to perform a CT scan. MRI is coming at the moment. Literature forces MRI a little bit. PET CT is in discussion if it helps or not. And then you have to have video-assisted thoracoscopy to get a biopsy of these disease. And I think what I wanted to press out now is that if you perform a biopsy, any kind, you have to, if you have the mesothelioma in mind, that could be mesothelioma. So please think about how to proceed if you have to perform an open operation after chemotherapy or after you know what it is. So you can just do with a pencil, you can know this is the scar, what I'm going to do for if I do further surgery, and then you just can put up a lesion here or here, so this is easy to cut out if you perform surgery, because we have a very high rate on implantation of tumor cells in the scars, And you have to remove this if you have scars here, puncture here, puncture here, and puncture here. You usually can resect the whole thoracic ribs. So this is not good for the patient anyhow. And you also will evacuate the pleural fluid and have staging about other lymph node or other distant metastasis. And perhaps you have circulating tumor markers, but at the end they are not very helpful because they are not specific. And so at the end we don't do it, we don't use them. We have a staging system for pleural mesothelioma, which means that you have a primary tumor which is limited to the parietal pleura, or it is involving the visceral pleura, or it is involvement of the diaphragm, visceral, or in the lungs, and so on. And just to make it here, you have the very good prognosis in local situation on the pleura, which easily can be removed with a pleurectomy. You have the situation that the disease gets up into the mediastinal situation or as well as going up to the diaphragm, a bulky disease with lymph node metastasis, which you can see here, and even though the prognosis is getting worse. We know that the epithelioid mesothelioma has the best prognosis in these patients, and the worst is according to sarcomatoid type of pleural situation. And the TMN stage, as I just demonstrated, is not that prognostic value. So if you know that you have a stage three situation, this doesn't demonstrate you the real effect, more or less. And even though if you distribute to the histology, so epithelioid, biphasic, and sarcomatoid, you see according to the stage, there's no significant difference. So at least you have to know the histological type and be aware to have a complete surgery. We will see what we can say there. So the first line chemotherapy was proven for pleural mesothelioma is to combine cisplatinum with pemetrexate. If you combine this, you will have a much more a response rate, 41% compared to 17%. So this combination seems to be very impressive in results. Also, the overall survival is significantly better than without pemetrexate, and if you combine these situations with bevacizumab, so at the moment these are the best results which you can achieve for pleural mesothelioma. But anyhow, just to summarize, cisplatin, pemetrexate, bevacizumab for chemotherapy, perhaps for induction chemotherapy in these kind of patients, can be a very good situation. We have new therapies in malignant pleural mesothelioma. They are going from anti-angiogenic therapy with bevacizumab, what I just demonstrated to you. They come from mutation situation, from next generation sequencing, which is here. They have clinical trials on the way, and also for tumor suppressor genes where they have these pathways and have these kind of new drugs which they give. But very impressive and very promising are the immunotherapy treatment in mesothelioma with the PD-L1 antibodies. They seems to be quite impressive for results. And of course, you have other lines, what we are going for. I think this is future. But at the moment, we have to also to think about surgery. I think this is also very important to get these patients to surgery. together with other trials, as you can see here, if you put surgery in the treatment regimen of a patient with a malignant pleural mesothelioma, you see that we have significant better results if we can remove the tumor burden, but which is not in the sarcomatoid type. Therefore, we have to be careful to offer the patient surgery, even if it is an advanced situation. So we have to think if we do this. What possibilities and what kind of surgery do we deliver to the patients? So we have lots of possibilities. This is one from former times, I will say now. It is the extra pleural pneumonectomy, which means that you completely en bloc resect the pleura, the pneumonectomy and the visceral pleura as well as the pericardium. This is so you just take everything out, even with the pericardium, so nothing is left. But even though these kind of surgery are not are zero at the end, and you have the possibility, you have to perform an extended pleurectomy or dissection. Or only pleurectomy in several cases. So this is what we can offer at the moment. This was a case, I did this now 20 years ago, something like this, and I performed EPP, so an extrapleural pneumonectomy with the resection of the pericardium. We put then here a flap on it. But this patient, I must say, he survived, yes, and he lived 1 year, but he had bad, condition. So he was not able to take one stair. He was very much had a bad life quality of life. So I think this is not this is nothing which we should offer our patients. Extended pleurectomy means that you can dissect the pleura from the diaphragm, also from the thoracic situation, but you are not at zero at the end. But what you do, you leave the lung inside, and these patients have power to go, and they even though because they have no pleural effusion afterwards, so they have a better quality of life. And what you are doing is that you just dissect the pleural situation, and this is